Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand with a quick overview of what's new in Mocha Pro 2024.5. Let's get right into it. On the tracking and rotor side of Mocha, we've added a bunch of new tools and exports to make life a bit easier. First up, when rotoing edges with motion blur, previously you had to look at the actual matte render to check out the extent of the blur. In Mocha Pro 2024.5, you can now preview an optimized version of the motion blur directly on top of your usual matte preview. This makes it much easier to see where your edges are and adjust accordingly. In 2024, we introduced Extrapolate Track for planar tracking, which creates tracking keyframes based on the motion of previous frames. In 2024.5, we've now added that support to PowerMesh tracking. This means you can extrapolate past difficult areas of your mesh track without ramping up the smoothness, making for more organic tracks with less adjustment. While we're on PowerMesh, we have implemented the Transform tool in Edit Mesh Mode, so you can easily adjust multiple vertices in the mesh just like you can with spline points. You can never have too many tools for helping with tracking, so we've added a new highpass filter to the pre-processing options, so you can now pull out more details and edges in your shot. This is especially helpful when combined with the other pre-processing tools such as contrast and gamma. In Fusion 19, Blackmagic introduced the MultiPoly node, which greatly reduces the amount of polygon nodes you need in your flow graph. As such, Mocha Pro now supports this format, so you can export multiple roto layers to the same node in Fusion and the Fusion page in Resolve. You will, of course, need version 19 for this to work. We have some new support for the 3D side of SynthEyes, which we'll look at later, but on the 2D side, we can now export planar and PowerMesh 2D tracking directly to the SynthEyes SNI format. This means you can export all your tracking work to SynthEyes without having to do a 3D solve first. Speaking of 3D, we introduced a complete overhaul of the Camera Solve module in 2024, and in Mocha Pro 2024.5, we've expanded on those tools with some highly requested features. Solve meshes in the Camera Solve module now project the footage frame directly onto the mesh, so you can get a preview of what the UV map reference frame will look like on export. You can preview textures in camera and perspective modes, or turn them off in the view controls. If a planar track is used in the Camera Solve, the surface will now convert to a 5.3D mesh plane, so it's easier to line up shots in the view. These planes will also be textured like the solved power meshes. If you're previewing imported models inside the 3D view, the position of the model will now be exported with the rest of the nulls, making it easier to set up your shot in your target host. For SynthEyes and Alembic exports, the link to the model itself will also be exported as a reference, positioned in the shot and ready to use. On that point, we've also expanded the export options to include the Alembic format, which is a highly flexible alternative to FBX and USD. The export options have also been updated to be a bit more user-friendly, making it clearer what specific items you're exporting for the different formats. The tracking pre-processing options are now also available inside the Camera Solve module, so you can punch up the details in your shot before auto-solving. These controls are completely independent of the track pre-processing options, so you can retain different settings for either module. If you want to visualize more points within the 3D scene but don't want to blow out your auto-solve time, we've ported over the Many Trackers feature from SynthEyes. In Mocha Pro, just increase the Add More Trackers field to add points between the already tracked parts of a solve, reducing the risk of a bad solve while increasing the number of points. Just be aware that, of course, more points doesn't necessarily equal a better result, but this feature does help make a denser point cloud. Because there can be hundreds, if not thousands, of points in a solve, we've also added some filtering options to the 3D objects panel. Along the top of the panel, you can choose to filter specific points by color, visibility, or selection, making it easy to work with just the objects you need. The filtering doesn't extend to the 3D view itself, so you can still work with any visible points in the view while having a curated list in the object tree. Speaking of colors, you can now also customize the 3D view defaults in the Mocha preferences, along with the size of the features in the view. A small but very helpful change to the camera solving is the ability to invert masks. This means rather than having to mask everything but the area you want to solve, you can now just mask the solve area and invert it to ignore the rest. Inside After Effects, we've added 3D camera data generation to the Mocha Pro Adobe plugin, so you don't have to copy data to the clipboard. This also includes the ability to generate lights instead of nulls, which are far more efficient in the After Effects 3D view. We've also now included the Paste Mocha camera features into the Mocha Pro Adobe plugin itself, so you don't need to install a separate importer to paste 3D data from the clipboard. The Mocha Pro 2024.5 plugin now also fully supports the OCIO features in recent versions of After Effects, so you'll get a more consistent color profile between the two applications. Finally, we've updated the Python API to give more convenient access to PowerMesh properties and selection states for vertex and control points in your projects. Mocha Pro 2024.5 crams in a lot of new updates for veterans and beginners alike. If you want to find out more about the more prominent features or check out quick tips and tutorials, go over to the website at borisfx.com.